Whoa, now like we always do around this time, I am your host, Mike Man, back with another episode of RAPPERWEED TV. Now we does the flame if you got them. Big backwoods burning. Punch that subscribe button when it's loud and lit loud. Circle forming because of COVID, we not passing. I need 12 feet fair, 6 for the COVID, 6 feet open air blunt. You tap the notification button, we got a circle chip. Everybody got this stimmy chick buying up all the goddamn backwoods. What the fuck, bro? Y'all need to slow down. Hey, man, we've made a story. Well, we were creating content on this story. And just like that, shit changes. Well, it changes a little. I'm talking about this Deshaun Watson, quarterback of the Houston Texans. Basically, he had, he just found out this week that he had some lawsuits, against him pending. But see, this is the red flag for me, right? Everything is alleged to have been executed, set up, and orchestrated on social media. Now, I'm going to be perfectly honest with you. NFL quarterback with a $156 million contract. You mean to tell me he's going to be soliciting and looking for a massage therapist on social media? Like, we living in an age where motherfuckers will try to scam you off of anything. Goddamn piece of penny candy, nigga, will scam your ass into thinking that shit worth $20 when it's worth 2 cents. Case in point, these allegations just surfaced and were discovered on social media by attorney Tony Busby, who is apparently representing all six ladies. All six ladies who have yet to file a criminal charge, who have yet to file a criminal complaint. But everything is alleged to have occurred over the 2020 season. Seeing how folks waiting on stimulus money, and the economy had to be stimulated 3 times. You mean to tell me somebody who may or may not have a case against a quarterback that plays in the NFL, who recently signed a contract years ago for $156 million, but now that he wants out of Houston, now all of a sudden all these allegations come up? I mean, to me, I'm going to tell you something, bro. This shit is like a form of fucking slavery. And it makes you, if it doesn't make you think about a lot of shit, it should. Like, for one, I'm going to say this. If y'all have the resources and money to build a black man up, where he'll have generational wealth for years and years and decades, but the mere hint of some foul shit and y'all tearing him down, dragging his fucking name through the mud, trying to paint him out to be this, when all of these years he's been nothing but exemplary, charitable, and productive on the football field. So, I mean, all that other shit, I mean, all this shit should be, it's just flags. It should be flags, I ain't gonna lie. And if Houston players, the black ones mostly, y'all sit there and let that man get railroaded like this, whether he on your team or not, guess what? After he's gone, who you think next? Who you think they looking at next? So if you don't think for one moment. This shit ain't no form of slavery where they try to control your ass and control the narrative. Unless you play ball. Oh, my bad. Unless you shut up and play ball. Like, bro, what this shit looking like to you? I mean, a spade is a motherfucking spade. And all, when he signed that, this is my bro. When he signed that $156 million extension or contract or whatever the fuck he signed, when he signed that for $156 million, don't you think, had there been any allegations or any misconduct, do you not believe that shit would have surfaced years ago? Especially when he first signed that $156 million contract or extension or whatever. Or even when he got to the league. Don't you think this shit would have surfaced then? Had he been this type of player, don't you think Houston would have heard this type of shit by him? Oh, he like to get freaky ass massages. Like, come on, bro. Y'all can call this shit what you want to, but that shit damn near a form of slavery. Motherfuckers trying to control, and shit, ain't no other way to put that shit, bro. It is what it is, and everybody can see that shit. Like the timing, nah, no, I don't believe that shit. I believe it's coincidences, but shit, not like that, bro. That shit is too coincidental. Like, really, he wants out. Now he gets 6 lawsuits pending. Now the NFL wants to investigate. Like, come on, bro. NFL, y'all find out when motherfuckers having misconduct issues and all this, and y'all have PIs, private investigators, and all this, and y'all find out shit on a regular basis about people. So, how did this slip through the crack? Oh, my bad. Let me guess. The COVID. Well, if it was COVID and COVID protocol and during the COVID season, don't you think we should have been quarantining and... Yeah, nothing. We just gonna call this shit what it is. If you don't see what the fuck going on, if you don't realize what the fuck going on, guess what? When it's your turn to get up in front of the firing squad and your ass is on that line, and they holding that shit up ready to blast your motherfucking ass in half and tear your whole life down, that's when that shit will hit you. But until then, I don't know. Y'all let me know what y'all think in the comments. Punch that subscribe button in when it's loud. Little loud, so perform because of COVID. I can't pass. Biggest of the backwoods burning, man. Go ahead and hit that subscribe. Notification bell. Give me 12 feet. 6 for the COVID. 6 for your printer. You over there. I'm over here. Yeah, we good. It's up. And y'all stay tuned, man. It's fire how they doing that, boy. But guess what? Every black man in America, they'll get that type of treatment if they don't shut up and play ball. You know what I mean? Y'all continue to be safe, be breezy, stay dangerous, stay sanitized.